I heard that you might need to slow it down with the drinking because you might be getting a little too loose.
Yo.
That's what they said on the report card.
On what?
The report card.
I thought you were talking about some real shit.
No, I don't know anything about
it. I thought you were talking about some real shit. Nah. You know, my name Flawless, for real.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. My name might as well be Flawless.
So do you guys resent me sending you the report card?
Just when you say, oh, yeah, you should look at this. Well, once I looked at it and I heard speaking on grading, crippin, only crazy. Certain people can do that.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? This is not the rap report card. Any could pop up. No shade to Dijon. Anybody could pop up and give their judgment on music, but you can't come judge this crippin. It's a whole different
so
thing.
So for me, from my perspective, I'm feeling like the person narrating it seems like they know what's going on.
So that's the thing, right? Your perspective don't really mean nothing as far as this shit go. When it comes to some street shit or what have you, right? And you think it, see how he says only certain people can speak on, like, when it comes to certain shit. So even me, right? Me being an outsider of that culture, right? I kind of like tread lightly because I'm not a gangbanger. You know what I'm saying? I know about it and I got it in my family, this, that, and third, but I just be speaking on certain things from a street aspect, right? Coming from where I come from and coming from the inner city and, you know, this, that, and the third. So, you know, you don't know nothing about that, Grand Mason. You coming from wherever you coming from, out the way and, you know, where they do skateboarding shit at, right? You done got fascinated with this shit, so now you feel like, and you feel like you done learned a lot. I'm going to break it down. Just stay with me.
Your perspective?
I mean, and I'm not the best
at judging. That's exactly what I mean.
That's what I'm saying.
To me, it sounds like he's got a decent perspective. You're telling me that it's not coming across the...
First of all,
I don't know.
Do you even want me to shout it out so people can go see what grades you got?
The
Crip report card.
It ain't nothing bad.
Full disclosure, you got a B.
That I got a D.
That's, yeah. But yeah, you...
And you that, feel like...
That's outside
you knowing me
in.
All these years, you feel like he know what he talking about?
No, that's one of my criticisms of it. Is I feel like when I look at it, that it's kind of like he's just going with like your most recent controversy.
Exactly.
And it's like because...
So the thing is, right, Brick, you asking Adam that, right, lets me know that he knows some shit that if it came down to it, he could divulge that information, right, to them people. And you even asking him what he think about this, that, and the third is strange to me because, like, I don't really, like, you know, I don't really care about his, you know, his opinion when it comes to that certain shit. But then, on top of that, right, he telling y'all about what y'all grade was to a motherfucker. He say, dude, sound credible, don't know who he is, and this, that, and the third. That's one thing, right? Then you say, you call yourself telling them about what grade they got as if you want them to step it up. You understand me? Or like yeah, nigga, or like you agree with that. You know what I'm saying? But of course you ain't gonna agree with it in his face. You know what I mean?
Got a D. Because at the end of the day, right, he don't know what he talk about. And if he did, my whole thing is the shit that he judging has nothing to do with crippin'. You gotta go off jail reports. You gotta go off ever turning down something or ever like when it's really active. You don't know what his score is. You don't know how many bodies he got because if a nigga know how many bodies you got, you going to jail.
Like for the person,
you know what I'm saying? Like
for
the
person making the video, I feel like that hat is probably not great for your score.
Yeah.
I feel like you could have maybe eked out a C- if it wasn't for the hat.
But listen to this, right?
They're going
to
judge you for the hat. It's wrong. Let me tell you, it's wrong.
Sound like some, this look, wrong. Look, I see a lot of... He going off watching the internet.
Yeah.
You know, and even just watching the internet is cool. That's judging off a person's character that you've been seeing. Off crippin', once again, you gotta know. You gotta be there. Like, you know, I've been in jail with niggas from his hood, with niggas from with certain niggas on that report card for real, and I could tell you how they crippin' is.
Yeah.
I could tell you.
So another thing too, right? You on here once again, Brick, talking about bodies and whoop whoop and trying to allude to certain things that I don't need to go down that road. You feel me? You done went far enough, but it's like, Adam, you still keep like see how you bring up, oh, he feel like that hat, like you he done made a, you know, in his mind, it's a trip because in his mind he thinks he done got a good grasp of who's who and what's what when it come to this shit. Like, boy. You don't know who's who and what's what. And you think because certain, like, it, like, it's like the loudest person in the room type shit. You know, he think the loudest crip and the one who talking about this or blood or whatever, right, is the one you gotta be watching out for. But really, it be ones that's silent, boy. Like gas, silent and deadly, boy. And well, and also, you know, you just, bro, I'm gonna keep it lit, man. And then I'm gonna really bust down.
You how a nigga crippin is, exactly. For real. And I could tell you what certain niggas can't even survive, for real. And rapping saved a lot of niggas. You know what I'm saying?
See, you're coming off of an alleged W because you came out looking pretty good in the big sad beef. So they're gonna give you a good one. But I feel like if you were like at a period where all anybody had been talking about, like say you had a viral moment on Wildin' Out, they're gonna be like, you know, DW, I feel like he's kind of a Nick Cannon crip now. Right, you're wildin' out crip. Right, he ain't really. TV crip, you know?
And I am. I'm a TV crip too. I'm a universal crip. So my shit is beyond a report card. Mm. Fuck a crippin'. Fuck just like a crip report card. I'm an outstanding member.
Grade this mask, right? But you gotta understand, I started a whole gang in this mess. That's deeper than a lot of niggas' hoods out here.
Okay, but let's be real.
So, I've heard enough for now, right? Yeah, and you can go check out the rest of the clip, the finish, if you wanna see it. It's Brick Baby, the report card, the Crip report card on No Jumper Clips, right? So, you know, one thing that trips me out is, you know, Adam seems like he's pushing. You know what I mean? For you to step your crippin' up, right? Them two. And it's crazy for, you know, this guy to be acting like you got some say-so and who's crippin' right and ain't crippin' right, this, that, and the third. And it's like, at first, right, with the crew he had with T-Rail and AD and them, I feel like he was considering them to be like, Like now after dealing with Brick and DW, right, he would try to consider AD and T-Rail and them party crips or whatever have you. You know what I'm saying? No disrespect. I'm just saying this is how Adam thinking. You know, he trying to judge people on how he think he know what's going on in the culture enough to where he can, you know, kind of like judge and see who's who and what's what. Another thing, right, he was up there being super messy talking about some, because I guess DW brother had came in, right? The one who posted had snatched Brick up and this, that, and the third. And he bring up the situation like, man, what happened? I say he snatched you up. And DW, what happened, bro? You co-signed that shit. What's up? Like, he's going out his way to, you know, get controversial moments and be thirsty. Like, I seen him the other day, day before yesterday or something, right? He walked in the building with a thong on, pants sagging, and whoop, after getting caught on a date with a male porn star that be doing, you know, males on camera. You know what I'm saying? So they caught them on a semi-date or some shit, and he, you feel me? He tried to call himself playing on it by coming in there doing that weird shit. But it's weird, right? Because, like, so how he came in there with that thong, right? This is what I mean by that. Like, certain things is allowed and understand that your employer, right? But, you know, just certain things would not be accepted from certain people in certain areas. But they allowing bro to do what he do as far as, like, come in sagging thongs, sex playing niggas, acting like you can, you know, not getting offended when he talking about you tell a nigga his grade. Like, you tell me my grade on the crib report card. Well, you don't know nothing about that. Don't tell me no grade, bro. I don't want to hear that from you. That's not, you know. But the thing is, like, it's a trip, right? Because on one end, you got these cats right here. Like, Brick, he say, I ain't talking about politics no more. Whole time, your boss, that's what he wanted. That's what he know where the money at. It's crazy because Academics spoke on this shit, man. He say, oh, Brick and them think they there to be, like, the next great podcasters and this, that, and the third. No, you're strictly there to crash out, nigga, and talk about gang politics and be exploited. And I don't understand what a nigga gonna understand that. And I don't understand how a nigga don't understand that. But if it was a nigga, right, a nigga asking certain questions or doing certain things, nigga like, nigga, this nigga the police, nigga, whoa, nigga trying to, you know. Bruh, these niggas, y'all niggas, let me know what y'all think.